morning, madam. Today I'm going to present my paper on Ayurvedic Heart Diagnostic Techniques to Develop Modern Non-Invasive Disease Diagnostic Devices. So this is a conceptual paper. So I'm going to explain the aim of this paper, and then I will explain what is Ayurvedic medicine is and what is the pulse analysis techniques in Ayurvedic medicine, especially the wrist pulse analysis. And then I will explain about electronic devices for wrist pulse analysis, and then I will conclude the presentation. So aim of this presentation is to arise the need of non-invasive low-cost diagnostic devices, because in developing countries like Sri Lanka, for the diagnostic purposes, especially they are using medical imaging and laboratory tests. In medical imaging, they have to undergo radiation where side effects are possible. And also, these medical imaging systems are very expensive for a developing country. Some of the patients can't afford those techniques. And also, for the laboratory tests, they have to undergo invasive procedures where they can expose to another diseases. So I'm suggesting fusion of wrist pulse analysis using Ayurvedic medicine and modern electronics as a solution to overcome this problem. So first of all, I would like to tell what is Ayurvedic medicine is. Ayurvedic medicine is an impressive, unique technique originated in ancient India. In there, they believe that every human being is composed with five components, that is water, earth, fire, ether, and air. According to this constitution, they have differentiated people into vata, pitta, kapha. So, pulse analysis is one of the major diagnostic techniques used in Ayurvedic medicine. There are nine prominent points where they sense the pulse to do the diagnostics. Actually, in my concept paper, I would like to address radial artery point, which is used by most of the Ayurvedic people. That is wrist pulse analysis. Normally, they call it wrist pulse analysis. In that case, they are measuring the pulse at radial fossa by using three fingertips, as shown in the right corner picture. So, the basic theory of wrist pulse disease diagnostic is based on Prakruti and Vikruti. So, there are seven levels of radial pulse reading according to the Ayurvedic medicine. Sensing of the first level is known as Vikruti, and it indicates the current situation of the patient. And sensing the deepest level or the seventh level is known as Prakruti, and that contains the level of the person from the beginning. So, for a healthy person, this Prakruti and Vikruti are similar, but for an unhealthy person, this Vikruti is deviated from the Prakruti. So, that is how Ayurvedic technicians or the practitioners made the diagnostics. So, there can be an inaccuracy of wrist pulse reading due to the wrong finger position. So we know that these Ayurvedic practitioners do lots of practice, and with the experience they become experts. But and also, if the patient have a thick fat layer, it can also interrupt the sensation. Also, the premature births and umbilical cord strangulation also affect the pulse of a person from the birth. So they said that questioning the patient is important. And to overcome these problems, we can use electronic sensors, because sensors are more reliable than non-experienced Ayurvedic practitioner. So there are so many researchers done in this section. I mentioned only few. In these researchers, they have used several kind of sensors, such as piezoelectric sensors, piezoresistive sensors, IR optical sensors, and also ultrasonic sensors. they have used processing software such as MATLAB and LabVIEW to process their data. Finally, some of these people could able to differentiate people into Vata, Pitta, Kapha according to the Ayurvedic practitioners, and they have confirmed their differentiation using these softwares and all with the Ayurvedic practitioners. So there are 100% accurate systems developed up to now. And also some people have differentiated people from normal person with some diseases. Like I have shown one which is carried out by Ashok Bhatt in 2008. He could able to differentiate person with back pain, person with stomach ache, and person with fever from the normal person's parts. So, additionally, Chen and his fellows paired wrist pulse using a Doppler sensor, and he could differentiate acute appendicitis patients from normal healthy person, and he could acquire 82% of accuracy, which lead us to do more research on this thing. And also, David did a case study, and she could see that doing this non-invasive diagnosis by Ayurvedic practitioners give the 100% accuracy results, similar results such as results given by biopsy and CAT scan. So she suggested that these can be used to diagnose cancers. Especially, we know that to do diagnose a cancer, we have to undergo CT scan and such medical imaging where we have to expose to radiation, and that cause several side effects to the patient additionally to the cancer. So this is I believe that this is a turning point of this research field. So the conclusion of my presentation is that non-invasive diagnostic devices might be developed with help of fusion of Ayurvedic medicine and the modern electronic systems to reduce the cost and time of the diagnostic. And also, I think it might be a good approach to protect the declining valuable technique of Ayurvedic medicine. These are the references I have used, and I would like to acknowledge Dr. K.M.P.G. Premadasa, Mr. W.L.P.K. Vijay Sinha, Mr. A. Palavala, and Ms. N.S. Balakarnu for supporting to this presentation. Thank you.
Thank you very much for an interesting presentation. This is now open for questions.
Will they give the information to you? Because your program will be able to analyze. But if you don't know what to analyze, the program will be useless.
After getting the data, they have confirmed their differentiated data with the 5-ready practitioners.
No, if you have one or two things like fever, it might be okay. But when you don't know what the disease you are looking for, you don't know how to be able to do it, have a database to do it.
Yes, we can develop a database. We can increase our sample size, and after that we can acquire from several diseases data, and we can differentiate the normal health persons.
You proposed non-invasive diagnosis technique for cancer. So have you taken statistics, what is the wholesale average, like how many samples you have tested?
Actually sample size is not given, but yes.
What is wholesale average?
She has told that 100% she got the data from...
Isn't that yours?
Yes. But they got big biopsy and CAT scan.
Is it like a standalone research, or is it together with the practitioner, together to assist the practitioner?
Actually, there she...
Have they compared with like the control sample and then the sample...
Actually,
and
in that one...
So just one question at a time, please. So. First answer to the first question.
What she had done is, she had did a case study. In that case, what she had done is collected data from the Ayurveda practitioner and collected data for the same person from new technologies. And in that case, what she had done is that Ayurvedic accuracy of the Ayurvedic medicine is improved in that case.
How many Ayurvedic practitioners have they used
for the
study? Just one practitioner or across
No, they have used several Ayurvedic practitioners from China and also from India.
No, I mean all this data from a literature. I'm a strength clinician, but I'm also serving in the Ayurvedic Sutra Committee, which is the body that approves any new Ayurvedic formulation or treatment modality in Sri Lanka, formally. So we have a strict practice. Now, for example, acute appendicitis is not an Ayurvedic diagnosis. No, it's a Western diagnosis. It doesn't come within the 5 dose principle, you know what I mean? So whatever claims that are made have to be made within terms of Ayurvedic diagnosis, people can produce, right? Not, they are making claims regarding specific things. Now, they do make claims saying like that particular formulation will lower cholesterol. That is permitted if a clinical trial is done using Western techniques, the other controls are that, you know, otherwise they're not allowed. These are laws passed by the Ayurvedic clinical council itself to make claims like that. So this applies to the same thing. We also use pulse in diagnosis, but it is very straightforward. For example, with fever and pulse, we have a very straight, you know, every degree increase of fever, pulse goes up by 10. So we know that, even so we can allow this. But Ayurvedic pulse diagnosis is much more complex. They have, as you say, they have to be experienced things. I think Professor Lucas's question was a key one. Those secrets are usually limited to the family and learn, and they don't diverge, and it's a subtle variations in the pulse that they detect. They have perfected their fingertips to detect them over the years. To convert them into an electronic sensor, you have to know those subtle variations, and whether they will really diverge it to you or not, you do not know.
Okay, thank you very much for that. Awesome point. We're out of time. That one, so we just say thank you.